Good afternoon. Let us pray. Lord God, you made all things, and you encourage us to love you with our heart, our soul, our strength, and our mind. We honor you today in this place, Lee University, a Christ-centered, God-honoring institution. And we thank you for the diligence of every student here who reasoned, endured, and studied to demonstrate their skills and their leadership and to earn their degree. May you bless their efforts and the works of their hands. Amen.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is so great to see you all. On behalf of the Board of Directors, President and Mrs. Walker, the faculty, the staff, and the administration, I want to welcome you to the 181st commencement exercises of Lee University. To the family and friends who have gathered here today, and those of you joining us online, we are so honored to share this moment with you, and we know how proud you are of your graduates today. Why don't you show them? Over the next 24 hours in six ceremonies, we will confer 627 degrees from our six colleges and schools. Graduates from the Department of Communication Arts and the School of Music, congratulations. Today is your day, and we are very proud of you. There's a quote I want to share with you from an Adidas ad in the early 2000s. It says this: "Impossible is just a big word thrown around by small people who find it easier to live in the world they've been given than to explore the power they have to change it." Graduates, you possess a great deal of power. You possess the power of the relationships that you have built over the last 4 or 5 years. Never underestimate relational equity as a change agent. You have possessed the power of the knowledge and the skills that you've acquired with interaction with the faculty, staff, coaches, and directors. And most importantly, those of you who are in Christ Jesus possess the power of the Holy Spirit, who lives inside of you not only to direct your life and to comfort you, but to empower you to accomplish everything God's called you to do. Congratulations, we're proud of you, and remember, you will forever be a flame.
This morning, we would like to sing together. So if you'll look on the last page of our program, the words to our hymn, "Great is Thy Faithfulness," is there. Can we stand together as we sing?
Great is thy faithfulness, O God my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not, thy compassions they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever wilt be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter and spring. springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above. Join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and a peace that endureth, thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide, strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all thine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Thank you, Bill, for that hymn, and to Dr. Moffitt for that welcome, and to Ashley Freer, one of our board members, thank you for opening us up in prayer. Welcome to Spring Commencement 2021 on campus, in person, at Lee University. Yeah! We are so pumped to be able to do this. This is the first time we've been able to host commencement since December of 2019. And we're so excited and we're so grateful and we are glad that you are here. Now, we would have loved to have been all together in one place to celebrate all of our graduates, but obviously with COVID-19 protocols, with social distancing, we weren't able to do that. So this is the first of six ceremonies that we're going to have over the next 2 days, three today and three tomorrow. And those of you that are here in person, welcome. And those of you that are watching live streaming, welcome as well in our different venues. So what we're doing in each one of these ceremonies, we are combining different schools and departments. And so in this ceremony today, we have the Department of Communication Arts from the College of Arts and Sciences, and we have the graduates from the School of Music. So welcome, friends and family, the graduates. Graduates, congratulations. As Dr. Moffitt said, we are proud of you. Let me also recognize those who are on the platform. Over here to my far left, going all the way to the right, we have members of our board, as well as members of our presidential cabinet, and then also the deans and chairs of the respective schools and departments that are here today. Now, before we move any further, let's kind of recognize maybe who's in the room. Graduates, I think you're very much aware that you did not get here on your own. There are a lot of people that really did a lot of things for you so that you're sitting here in cap and gown about to receive your diploma. Now, I know this is going to be a little tricky and maybe a little sensitive because you only had a limited number of tickets to get your family or friends here in person. So whoever's here in person that we're going to recognize, those are obviously your favorites in your family. So hopefully that's not created a lot of drama for you. So let's see who's here. And if you're in one of our venues, if you'll stand there too, please, when I recognize you as how you might be connected to one of these graduates. So if you're a parent of one of our graduates. Would you please stand where you are? We want to recognize you. All right, yeah, good. Welcome. Congratulations. Now, let me just say this. We're about to recognize grandparents. If you stuck grandma or grandpa in a venue, you know, they're the ones that give you the big bucks. You just got discounted about 50%. I'm just telling you right now. But if you're a grandparent of one of the graduates in a venue live right here, would you please stand if you would, please? Wonderful. Welcome. Welcome. Glad to have you here. Do we have any siblings of graduates that might be in the room? Would you stand, please? All right, great. Excellent. That would have been one of the first ones I would have stuck in one of the other venues. If perhaps you're a spouse, do we have any spouses of some of our graduates that might be in the room? Fantastic. Welcome. Congratulations. And do we by chance have any children of any of our graduates that might be here? We have one way up there. You may be the only one. I don't know. Well, congratulations. We are glad all of you are here. Now, pre-COVID-19, in our commencement weekend, we would have had a commissioning service on the Friday night where our graduates would have received a Bible signed by the president, and you would have heard from some of our graduates as to their Lee stories. And then on Saturday, we would have had the traditional commencement with the commencement speaker and the receiving of diplomas. Well, in the COVID-19 version, we are combining elements from the commissioning service and the commencement exercises. So the graduates are going to receive a Bible signed by the president and the chancellor, as well as they will receive their diplomas also. And our commencement speaker is actually going to be two of our students sharing their Lee experience story. So let me introduce them to you, and they will come and share their stories. First coming is Julia Lava, is graduating summa cum laude with a Bachelor of Science degree and a major in Digital Media Studies Cinema. After her, Lauren Mills, who's graduating summa cum laude as well with a Bachelor of Music Education degree and emphasis in voice. Would you please welcome Julia Lava as she comes to share?
Hello, everyone. So here's what I'm not going to talk about in my speech. I'm not going to recount how my great-great-grandfather came to Lee 100 years ago, because he didn't. I am not going to tell you how I got an athletic scholarship that took me to a D1 championship, because I don't play sports ball. And I didn't meet the love of my life at Lee. But if you did, congratulations. But I was a film major, so let me tell you how I would film my acceptance to Lee. I would be riding on the back of an elephant through the streets of my hometown in South Africa. Paul Kahn himself would descend from the heavens and personally deliver my acceptance letter as a stone scroll. Of course, every film student knows we wouldn't get the funding for the elephant, and in reality, my acceptance letter was an email because the postal system in South Africa is really janky. Seriously, you cannot get any mail. Now, how I got from Pretoria, South Africa to Cleveland, Tennessee is a bit of a long story, and I've only got about 4 minutes left, so I'll jump back to my film major. In high school, I never saw myself as an artist. But after Professor Beecher Renning showed me all the impressive equipment in the digital media department, I was on board. I was confident that college would solve all of my insecurities about being an artist, and that my time at Lee would mold me into the most creative individual possible, with Hollywood-ready films literally oozing out of me. That's disgusting. But so is the concept that college education will solve all your insecurities. Reality is, I still struggle to see myself as an artist. And from this stage, I want to say that it is okay if you are insecure about pursuing a field you don't feel ready for. I do not have it all together. And I know a lot of you don't either, so let's stop pretending. But also, have grace for the 57 times we are going to be asked today. So, what are your plans now that you've graduated? It's okay not to know. What's not okay, and I am speaking fully to myself here, what's not okay is letting our insecurities stop us from pursuing that dream job or moving across the world or, I don't know, learning how to dance. And in the end, if you decide that what you thought was your dream job isn't actually what you want to do, don't let your fears stop you from changing course. Freshman year, I was pumped to be a filmmaker. I also didn't really know what that meant. And despite the amazing experiences on set and lifelong relationships I've made with professors, I just realized my personality is better suited to pursuing graphic design. But I'm going to be honest here. I do not have a job in graphic design yet. No one ever really admits that from this stage, but I know that so many of you are in the same position. So if it brings anyone comfort, just know that we're all in this together. Cue High School Musical. Okay, let's be honest here. You and I both know that in an hour's time, when you're outside celebrating with your families, you're not gonna remember my speech. It's okay. I cried my tears earlier. No, but seriously, it's okay because this is not about me. It's about us. And my hope is that you take away that college is not just about your degree. Whether you end up using it or not, for whatever reason, your college experience was more than this expensive piece of paper. Our successes and failures in college don't determine our future. Life is about laying down our lives on a daily basis in pursuit of Christ. Anything beyond that is abundance. I'm going to leave you with something my dad recently told me. Hi, Dad. He said that Jesus let people know two things, that they were known and that they were loved. And so we are called to do the same. Class of 2021, and those of you from class of 2020, wherever you find yourself in the next 5, 10, 20 years, let people know that they are known and loved. This life is a gift. Let us not waste it.
As a 10-year-old gal from Maryland, touring colleges with my older sister, I was immediately captivated by Lee University. Attending summer music camp my junior year of high school, I was further drawn in by Dr. Rogers' contagious passion for choral excellence, by Mrs. Frost's nurturing and skilled vocal instruction, and the community of believers dedicated to worshiping the Lord with their music and lifestyle. From these interactions, I knew Lee would be a place to challenge me as a scholar and musician while developing and nurturing my emotional and spiritual maturity. The tight-knit community of the School of Music has radically changed how I interact with others. Relationships form organically through countless hours of communal music making in ensembles and shared learning experiences among classmates. Conversations before class, like determining which faculty member resembles our favorite childhood TV and movie characters, and conversations during class that develop our skill sets to serve God's kingdom, sparked friendships that will last a lifetime. Facilitating study sessions for music history often included laughing through the pain, as well as earnest prayers for strength. Early morning handbell rehearsals with Mr. Vaught's legendary real deal coffee and dad jokes started the day with abundant joy as we acquired a new hobby. The Ladies of Lee service and ministry opportunities, bus rides and host homes, precious traditions, and styrofoam head choreography blessed me with nearly 100 sisters and 3 incredible directors over my 7 semesters. From being named Corral's Trip Mom when we traveled to Europe in December 2019 to co-conducting a rehearsal as an undergraduate, I have been blessed to create excellent music in a safe and encouraging environment. Relationships were also formed through seemingly random encounters. Befriending an elderly Lee alum in the audience of an opera theater performance established a routine of attending sports events and music together. Student-teacher coffee meetings that started by reading Pete the Cat left me in tears as I was first inspired by Pete's adaptability and positivity, then inspired in the same way by my fellow student-teachers and their accomplishments and experiential growth. Pairings and placements by first-year programs for Gateway teams surprised me at first, yet later gave me a best friend in my co-peer leader, two mentors in our cooperating instructors, and sweet friendships with our Gateway kiddos who are just growing up way too fast. Though these moments seemed like happy coincidences, I believe that there's no such thing. Lee University has taught me that excellent preparation produces intentional spaces. These intentional spaces pave the way for genuine relationships, and these genuine relationships are often used by the Lord in divine appointments. Divine appointment number one. The last concert of Chorale and Choral Union before the pandemic was titled, How Now Shall We Live?, addressing topics such as depression, death, grief, and ultimate hope in Christ. Timely. Our last piece, titled My Shepherd Will Supply My Need, engraved Psalm 23 on my heart, a scripture God would use to nourish my soul in a season of uncertainty. Divine appointment number two. First meeting through years of observations for Dr. Burgess's elementary music education courses, I was honored to be selected to student teach with Mrs. Kara Rogers, a highly respected elementary music teacher and Lee alum. In the most trying season of my life, battling the stress of full-time teaching, the frustration of unmet personal expectations, and the turbulent emotion of fractured relationships, I arrived at her classroom this March defeated. But Miss Kara, armed with the comfort and wisdom of the Holy Spirit, chose to intentionally walk through this season of life with me, reminding me to receive grace and joy and choose joy daily, to pause and give everything and everyone to Jesus, and to boldly live out my God-given calling to teach. And while I could recall stories of the Lord's faithfulness for you all day, I'm sure every single Lee graduate, faculty, and staff member in this room has at least one of their own. Friends, we have endured the challenge to accomplish great things as working for the Lord and not for man, and have earned our degrees along the way with cords and pins, awards, and medals. I'm convinced, though, that today wouldn't be nearly as meaningful if, when we recalled our achievements as well as our valleys, that we weren't reminded of the faces of those and memories of the one who so faithfully journeyed with us. I pray as we go forth into this new season that our excellent preparation here at Lee will help us serve our communities with the intentionality our alma mater modeled for us. In our relationships, may we listen before we speak. May we love well, and may we radiate the joyful hope that is found in Christ alone. And lastly, to paraphrase a piece that has become chorale tradition, may others look up and see no longer us, but only Christ. Thank you.
Oh, Mr. President, it is my great pleasure to present to you and our guests the Spring 2021 Lee University graduating class. The students here today have successfully completed the course of study prescribed by the faculty of this institution and are now qualified to receive the appropriate degree in their major discipline. On behalf of the faculty and on recommendation of the respective deans and chairpersons, I, as Vice President for Academic Affairs, present to you this graduating class for the conferral of the appropriate bachelor's degrees, with all the related honors and privileges. It will also be my pleasure to recognize those students graduating with honors, with high honors, and with highest honors, and the 2020 graduates participating in this ceremony. I commend this class to you and to the company of learned persons everywhere. From the College of Arts and Sciences, will the candidates from the Department of Communication Arts rise and approach the platform? Michaela Elizabeth Anderson from the class of 2020, summa cum laude. Rachel Elise Anderson, summa cum laude. Macy Evelyn Brown, summa cum laude. Savannah Marie Bryan, magna cum laude. Haley A. Charles, magna cum laude. Shannon Leslie Clark, cum laude. Abigail Monzel Connor, summa cum laude. Bethany Autumn Joy Dennis. Annie Riley Drews. Peyton Rose Heyman, summa cum laude. Riley McKenna Jones, magna cum laude. Celeste Donette Kelly. Oxandra Cupina, magna cum laude. Catherine Faith Lewis. Michaela Brianna Literal. Mackenzie Renee McGee. Caitlin Alyssa Minton, magna cum laude. James Lanier Newell. Victoria Hope Pace, magna cum laude. Sela Carol Maria Phipps. Janie Berenice Ramirez Granados, cum laude. Autumn Bethany Reed. Molly Maxine Sims, summa cum laude. Ashley Elizabeth Smith, summa cum laude. Claire Catherine Smith. Victoria Andrea Wilcher, magna cum laude. Nicholas Stephen Allen. Zachary Lee Allen. Jordan Cole Anderson. Riley Claire Anderson, magna cum laude. Andrea Jude Bailey. Laura Renee Bailey. Brittany Ann Barker. Rihanna Ashley Barrow. Allie Marie Bennett. Matthew Stephen Birchfield. Shay Kai Chung. James David Cox. Benjamin Lee Conley, summa cum laude. Anna Lee Davidson. Jacob Andrew Ellison. Ashley Marie English. Blaine Wallace Eugene Faircloth, Jr., Class of 2020. Rachel Nicole Flanagan. Madeline Claire Gorman. Amy Jasmine Harrison. Rachel Lynn Hill, summa cum laude. Abigail Faith Holland. Austin Luke Roy Holland. Emily Aaron Jackson, class of 2020. Julia Lynn Laba, summa cum laude. Lauren Ashley Loudermilk, summa cum laude. Dylan Taylor Lumsden. Lily Marie Lee Mackey. Alexa Danielle Marmion. Alexis Kilton Matthews, cum laude. Ashley Caroline Morrell, cum laude. Lindsay Marie Nikas, cum laude. Chandler Voss Redding. Bryn Elizabeth Reynolds, class of 2020. Donovan Richard Chatham Reynolds, summa cum laude. Noah James Rodden, class of 2020, summa cum laude. Chandler Alexandra Sharp. Tiffany Brooke Sims, class of 2020, magna cum laude. Jonathan Rob Triber. Caitlin Mariah Waters. Whitney Ryan Wilkins. Ethan Jeffrey Wright, summa cum laude. Will the candidates from the School of Music please approach the platform? Yeah. Mackenzie Ray Abbott, magna cum laude. Eric Matthew Broom. Sarah Marie Carson, class of 2020, summa cum laude. Megan Nicole Foster. Lindsay Ray Gore. Jarrett Tyler Jacobs. Meredith Rose Livingston, magna cum laude. Jessica Marie Morales, class of 2020, cum laude. Michelle Celeste Motter. Luke William Roberts. Kathleen Rebecca Talley. Julia K. Bobel, summa cum laude. Lydia K. Bobel, summa cum laude. Cecilia Rose Fornuto, summa cum laude. Michael Gregory Gebhardt. Aiden Nicholas Hedrick, summa cum laude. Sarah Jane Pyatt, magna cum laude. Coleman Patrick Smart, magna cum laude. Jonathan Carl Smith, class of 2020, magna cum laude. Melody Elise Williams, magna cum laude. David Joseph Cruz. Emily Grace Dinkin, magna cum laude. Olivia Nicole Feeney, class of 2020. Ashley Nicole Garner. Courtney Michaela Grimes, cum laude. Hannah Noel Kendrick, magna cum laude. Lauren Elizabeth Mills, summa cum laude. Bryce Allen Reddick. Megan Marie Schlebaugh, summa cum laude. Jacob Evan Schwartz. Nicholas Ruben Barbosa. Riley Nicole Taylor. And from the Division of Adult Learning, Brooke Hannah Robson, class of 2020.
Class of 2021 and 2020, please stand. Thank you, Dr. Hayes, for presenting the Bibles. You have a diploma in your hand that signifies your accomplishment during your time here at Lee. But the Bible that you hold is what will guide your life in all that you do, and may it be truly near and dear to your heart as it takes you closer to God and brings God closer to you. You guys ready to do this? I don't hear very much enthusiasm. You guys ready to do this? Class of 2021 and those from the 2020 class, you may turn your tassel. Congratulations. You may be seated. In every commencement, we recognize those faculty members who have been serving Lee faithfully for 25 years, as well as we recognize faculty members for outstanding performance throughout the year. These commencement exercises will be no different. However, we're just going to recognize these members. The ones we're going to recognize aren't here in this particular ceremony because their particular school wasn't represented. But I want you to know who they are anyway. We have two faculty members who are receiving the 25-year Faculty Service Award, and that's Dr. John Heise from the Department of Natural Sciences and the College of Arts and Sciences, and Dr. Laura Anderson from the Department of Early Childhood, Elementary, and Secondary Education out of the Helen DeVos College of Education. Can you give them a congratulations and round of applause for their service to Lee for 25 years? And then every year we have three Excellence of Servants Awards that we present to three faculty members for outstanding performance in a particular area, either advising, scholarship, or teaching, and we want to recognize those. Excellent in Advising Award for this year goes to Dr. Chad Schrock from the Department of Language and Literature. Also, Excellence in Scholarship for 2021 goes to Dr. Alexander Stefanel, also from the Department of Language and Lit. And the Excellent of Teaching Award for 2021 goes to Dr. Heather Qualiana of the Department of Behavioral and Social Sciences. Would you recognize them, please, for their accomplishment? And we congratulate them as well. I invite you to stand for the singing of our doxology. You'll find the words printed on the very last page of the program. Following the doxology, our benediction will be brought by Chancellor Paul Kahn.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, you before whom angels bow and for whom this whole world is your footstool, we come this afternoon in profound gratitude that you have brought us all together at Lee University. We thank you for these students, for the homes you've brought them from. We thank you for every hour of effort, every late night, every dream fulfilled and unfulfilled. We thank you for their great promise and for their many callings. We thank you for the homes from which they've come, for their parents,
for those sacrifices their parents have made. We thank you for this faculty who've poured into them, not just intellectual content, but heart and soul. We thank you because you've brought us all here together to enjoy this experience, to learn from one another, and to learn from you. And we pray now, Heavenly Father, that as you have given these students to us, we give them back to you joyfully as an act of worship with great expectations. We pray now that by your Holy Spirit, by the love of Jesus Christ that dwells within them, that you will go with them, comfort them in every sorrow, rejoice with them in every victory. Take them to those places that you, only you, can know wait for them. And may you always keep these students and all of us close to your side until we all gather together someday with you. We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.